So now in this operation, although to release any prisoner from imprisonment is appreciated, and with the human dimension is very, very, what we call welcome. But we have three observations here on this operation of exchange of prisoners. First, the insistence of the Israeli governments in order to deport around half or 50% of those who were released have been deported either to Gaza or outside. Around 103 persons have been deported to Gaza, and 40 have been deported to outside, to different countries outside of Palestine. Those who have been deported outside, they are not allowed to travel out of the country that they have been deported. So they are as if they are still confined, but in a bigger jail. And also those who have been deported from the West Bank and Jerusalem Heights to Gaza, they are confined in Gaza. First, the West Bankers who have been deported to Gaza, they are away from their families, from their wives, from their beloved persons, and you can imagine the social problems could happen for a lady, for a wife, who were waiting for her husband more than 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, waiting for him to be released and to hug him and to live with him in their nest, in their home, with their children if they have, or on the hope that they can have a baby after such long period. Imagine the feeling of this wife who were waiting and now her husband is deported to Gaza, that she cannot see him. They cannot be gathered in under one ceiling. Imagine the feeling of this. This is a very destructive feeling for this woman, also for the man, for the person who were living with this hope day and night to hug his wife, to live in his home, to return to make some sort of flashback with nostalgia to those very sweet days that they spent together in the fiancé period or in the marriage period that they spent together, delivered children if they have. So this is the first very destructive, and this insistence of the Israelis, I do not understand why. I do not understand. This pretext of security is always raised, and this pretext of security, if the Israelis did not get rid of this nightmare called security, they will lose deeply. They will lose, first of all, their human sense. They will suffer with their children, with their families, from this feeling. The Israelis, they should get rid of this inferiority and superiority complex. Otherwise, they will not move forward. Without getting rid of this superiority and inferiority complex, peace is not attainable. We have a proverb called in Arabic, says, Wise suspects while ignorant assures. And allow me to be an ignorant for 2 minutes in front of you and assure you that without getting rid of this complex, of this superiority and inferiority complex, the Israelis will not be able to sit down around a table with eye level, with the same level with the Palestinians, without the feeling of the superiority, and in order to conclude a peace agreement. Exactly as if the feeling of inferiority, this feeling of inferiority within the Israeli community, and that they inject through history education, through social studies education, they inject it into their children, that Europe should feel with this feeling of guilt. Europe and the outsiders, as if the whole world is the enemy for the Israelis, and they are pursued from everybody all over the world. Only they are, oh, we are alone. This feeling, this culture should get rid of the Israelis. Otherwise, durable, lasting peace in the Middle East is not attainable, I assure you. And even internal peace inside the Israeli community with different factions, with different cultures, with difficulty they can live with, but they cannot attain. They can live with, but they cannot obtain, and it could not be obtained by the Israeli community. So this is the first thing, the deportation, the insistence of deportation, as they deported Palestinians from their homeland in 48, this culture of deportation should disappear from the Israeli policies. Second thing, and before jumping to the second thing, now the third category, first, those who deported outside, in Turkey, in Qatar, and other countries, Syria, or deported from the West Bank to Gaza. Now the Jerusalemites who were deported from Jerusalem, the Palestinian Jerusalemites prisoners who have been released and deported into Gaza. Now they cannot travel outside of Gaza, even if they are allowed. They cannot travel. Why? Because traveling outside of Gaza should need a passport. And once the Palestinian Authority issues passports for Jerusalemites, the Israeli Authority will raise this as a cause, a pretext, as a cause that they should lose their right of citizenship and residency in Jerusalem. So in order to make some sort of preference or priority, to prioritize for a certain Jerusalemite person, she or he, prisoner, if he'd like to prioritize between keeping his right and keeping his ID, his identification as a Jerusalemite, and live in Jerusalem and have the right to live in Jerusalem, or to lose this right, they will certainly prefer to keep their right to live as Jerusalemites in their home in Jerusalem. By this Israel government, and here I'm not aware about the details of concluding this prisoners exchange, but I blame the Palestinian negotiator accepting this, of course. Explicitly and publicly, I blame accepting this because this violates the human rights law. This violates the Fourth Geneva Convention. This violates the international humanitarian law that Israel, as well, the Palestinians should abide to. Israel as contracting party, Israel should abide to the international humanitarian law and mainly to Fourth Geneva Convention and to the international human rights law, as well as the Palestinian negotiator should not accept any violation of the international humanitarian law, because you are day and night asking for implementation of the international humanitarian law on the Palestinian case. Why are you now accepting violating this international humanitarian law? This is a big problem for the Palestinian, and the result of this will appear in the coming few months, if not months, in the coming 5 years. The impact of this deportation and the agreement of the Palestinian negotiator for this deportation. Second thing, the restrictions imposed on the released prisoners in the West Bank and in Gaza, some of them are restricted not to get out of their towns or of their villages in certain areas that under the control of the Israeli army in the West Bank. And others should not leave the governorate that they live in. These restrictions also violates the right to freedom. This violates the right of any human being to exercise his willing or desire to travel or to move from a certain place to a certain place, to change address, or these rights are granted by the international human rights law and international humanitarian law.